Hey, what's up, everybody? The day is finally upon us. There's a Nintendo Switch in this office. It's crazy, right? Yeah, I know. I'm here with Corey from Nintendo. How you doing?
Good. How are you doing, man?
Good. Real good.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thanks for coming through. And you've brought 1-2 Switch. Yeah, we're going to do a little team battle here in this, I guess, mini game collection is...
Yeah, there's 28 different games. A lot of them are used face-to-face style of gameplay. Some of them use like HD Rumble of the Joy-Con, et cetera.
Yeah, so that's, I'm actually looking forward to, we've gotten a lot of questions specifically about HD Rumble, and that was the one thing coming out of New York that I hadn't tried. So it was like, I don't know, it shakes, but I haven't felt it. I've not felt it for myself, so I'm ready to feel it.
Awesome.
And of course, being a team battle, we do need a team. Mm-hmm. So also from Nintendo, we've got Valerie, who's gonna be come on stage real quick.
Yeah.
And
right.
From GiantBomb.com, I've got Drew.
Whoa!
Hi.
Whoa. Hey, Drew, you're really big.
All right. Yeah.
So Switch is real.
Yeah, the Switch is real, and we're gonna take you on. So talk about team battle mode. It says here it takes 30 minutes. It says supports up to 20 players, but that's not.
Oh wow.
Yeah, so you need at least two to play. You can have as many are in the room. The idea is that we're going to be playing a collection of games, and after each game, you could pass the Joy-Con to someone else on the team. Okay. So if you have a group of like 10 and 10, maybe like all five of those people are eventually going to get, you know, a turn to go, or 10 people or whatever.
Okay.
So yeah, we might just be taking turns. Or
if,
since we're from Nintendo, if you guys want to choose who plays what game, you could try to handicap us however you want to handicap.
I don't know. I feel like you've both been on the road playing this game for a while and have probably both become pretty savage at it. So we'll see how it goes. I remember being pretty okay at a couple of the games out of New York, but why don't
I haven't even seen
it. Yeah, you've not seen a Switch. Okay, well
these
controllers come off.
Okay, Joy-Con.
So we split into two teams here. Yeah. You guys are gonna be the blue team on the left.
Right.
We're gonna be the red team on the right. So we've pushed a button. We've each pushed a button now, and we're gonna see a kind of a giant game board, which filled up with most of the games from 1-2 Switch.
There's a few games.
There's 28 total games in 1-2 Switch. So in the bottom left, you'll see the start. Our game pieces are going to go into the start starting point, and just like a game board, you'll try to make it to the finish first.
Okay.
So randomly, it's going to choose a game first for us. Pick a player from Treasure Chest. Oh, all right.
Okay.
So Treasure Chest. We can stand for this. It's fine.
Okay.
We're gonna each hold a Joy-Con. Well, basically each game will start with an introduction video, which if you haven't played before is really good to watch. You can see how to play. So in this game, you're trying to unravel a treasure chest by twisting and kind of just the Joy-Con, right? And you'll see that chain slowly becomes unraveled. So
some of the games
won't be face to face.
Right. Okay. So there are some games. Okay. That was because everything I'd played previously was definitely built around not looking at the screen. Mm-hmm. But they're not all like that apparently.
Yeah.
So,
I don't think you could probably do this one very well without looking at the screen.
Okay.
So this one we don't need the Joy-Con strap for.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead, push a button.
All right.
To
we're gonna need to see these chests here.
The R button. There we go. Yep.
Captain.
So just go ahead and hold it sideways really quickly.
Yep.
It'll sync up and then press a button. Okay.
Got it.
So that highlighted blue part of the chain is what's next to twist for some moment. Oh my gosh. We're like spinning it really fast. Oh my gosh.
Wait, no.
If it's red, you're kind of getting it jammed there. Oh, you can kind of go backwards to get it unraveled. Oh my gosh.
You're almost there.
Oh my gosh. Come on.
I just want to know what's inside.
No, I've got it.
Oh, I don't know.
Almost got it. No. Oh.
Come on. Oh. No, too far. All right. Oh. Okay.
No!
Oh.
I was almost.
All right. It's money.
Congratulations.
It was money.
All right,
yeah.
You guys are off to a good start. You can see your score there, your time in the middle there.
36.90.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right, cool.
So you guys were the winning team. You will get the ability now to, by pushing a button on your Joy-Con, to spin the wheel to move your game piece forward.
Okay.
Closer to the finish. So go ahead and push A, B, X, Y, any of those face buttons there.
All right.
So you've got 1 through 5. You've also got a skull icon.
Mm.
If you land on that skull, you will lose your turn and you will get to roll.
I'm just gonna move out of the way a little bit.
One, all right. So we're here to play the mini games, so we want to take it slow.
Off to a fast start. Yeah.
It's a very Mario Party kind of roll.
I'm gonna pass it off to Valerie here.
Oh, okay.
Then
Zim.
Oh.
Alrighty.
My first time.
We'll watch the video here.
Yeah.
All right. So you can
nice
watch
balance.
Again, each video.
Okay.
Watch here. There's going to be different Zen poses. It's going to choose one for you to do. You'll hold the Joy-Con just like that. We'll give you the straps here.
Okay.
There you go. There's actually a shape here, so minus matches the minus, so it just goes just like
perfect.
That. So whatever pose you get, you're going to hold the Joy-Con as still as you can in your hand.
While not moving.
Mm-hmm. While,
okay.
While making noise? Is that what you said?
While making that pose.
Oh, yes. I thought you said like while making animal noises.
No, very
yes,
like,
I mean, yeah. Zen, you know, Zen. Yeah. Animal noises. Come on.
Whatever gets you to Zen.
So I'm going to ask you to throw the wrist wrap.
Oh, yeah.
Super quick for safety, Zen safety.
Yes.
So that's your pose. So go ahead and hold it just like that in your hand, extended, just like they're doing. Hold it. Hold it. Don't move. Don't move.
Two.
Stay as still as possible. You can look at your opponent too. It's actually encouraged to look at your opponent.
To throw them off.
Yeah. If you move, you'll lose points.
Bend those knees.
Yeah, they don't like your. Yeah, they don't actually. Hmm. So, did you hear that sound?
Yeah.
That means somebody moved.
Oh, okay.
Each time, yeah.
One of you looks like a true Zen master. The other, well.
Can you tell from the noise which player is moving? Is it like a different?
I actually have no idea.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm.
This goes on for quite a long time.
This is Zen.
You don't achieve Zen in 20 seconds. <It's>,
hold the pose for 5 seconds.
My legs aren't being very Zen.
Oh, it's almost good.
I feel like you can probably cheat.
Okay,
let's see.
Oh, Valerie!
Yeah.
So right here you can see each time your wick is burning, each time you move.
Oh, that's each time.
Yeah,
okay.
So Val was actually on the ropes. She came back. She was moving a lot.
What's the longest you've seen one of these go?
A Zen battle? Oh man.
Oh, it just if no one moves, it just keeps going? So it's like a staring contest almost.
Yeah, you were trying to get each other to
psych each other out.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so Val, go ahead and spin the wheel, see where we end
up
next.
Not moving is hard. I'm sweaty already.
Press a button to spin.
Is it possible to see the same game multiple times? Like if she were to roll a one right now, would it be Zen again? Okay, it'll skip the game.
A game will only show up once in team.
Okay,
we'll
skip that's cool. Faces with a check mark. Oh, I see.
One, two, three.
So this is the game you've been waiting for.
All right, cool.
This is HD Rumble. This is ball count.
Oh, wow.
Balls.
HD.
So the objective of ball count is to guess the number of balls that are inside the Joy-Con, right? They'll be, and we can sit down for this one. It's sometimes easier to get your.
Use the vibrations to try and figure out how many balls are in the box.
Balls.
Once you think you know the answer, pick a number. And set your Joy-Con down.
So we will actually. We can probably bring this in here for really quickly.
Sweet table here.
Yeah. Okay.
Produced.
All right. So we won't need the wrist strap for this one. Actually, this one feel pretty safe on ball count here.
So button on the back here.
Yeah, so while you're holding this white. While holding the physical button on the back,
To feel the balls rolling
just
around
inside. Pull up, okay.
Got it.
No, I don't. Oh, okay, that pull that
so
out.
While that's down, that's
while that's
fine.
Down.
Now push
the
release
button.
And it should slide right out.
Slowly tilt your Joy-Con left and right.
Like that. Ah, okay. Not enough force. I don't want to break it.
Oops.
What?
So there's a. So if you hold it flat in your hand right now,
use your control stick to guess how many
and tilt
balls
slowly,
are inside the box.
You should be able to feel the balls thunking
feel them
each
kind of
time
move
they
over.
Hit. Yeah. Sometimes the balls might bunch up, and so it might be trying to fake you out. But it is a box too, so going forward and backwards, you can shake up the balls as well in your hand to kind of break them apart.
Is the sound indicative?
It's really more about the HD rumble. We're feeling the funk. It's less about sound.
Set your Joy-Con down once you've made your guess. On this one.
It almost seems like the sound's there to throw you off.
Yeah.
No, don't listen to this.
So once you feel good, you'll use your control stick and set your Joy-Con down. I guessed three, you got four.
Do we have the same number of balls?
We do have the same number of balls. Oh!
All right.
You are
ball master.
Ball counting master.
That's what they call me for years now.
So now, this is actually really cool. You can actually see visibly where each one is hitting.
The balls are a lot smaller than I thought they
were. Mine were probably bunched up, which is why it felt like there were only three.
You take a bath
for
that.
All right.
Okay,
so you guys won, so you guys get to spin the wheel.
All right, okay.
See the next game.
How sure of that were you, Jeff?
I thought it could have been three. Okay. It took me a few times to go back and forth. Wait, no, that's definitely four.
Huh. Okay.
I felt pretty confident about four, but there were a few of the back and forth that I thought it might have been three.
So you needed all that time that you.
I did need every second of that time to determine.
The ball situation. Where are we going? What game are we going to? Push the button to stop it.
Could you have left the strap on?
We could have. Since it's an H game that's really all about HD Rumble, I'm trying to get like every kind of second out of it.
Sure.
Then have
them
grab your team. Every, I guess. Yeah. So this is milk.
All right, Drew. Now it's
Valerie,
a chance.
All right.
Are you good at milk?
We'll see.
All right.
Yeah, I'm good with it.
I've seen the animated GIFs.
You've seen the animated GIFs. All right.
Do I need to do it with my right hand instead?
What's your, what, you gotta determine, what is your milking hand?
Yeah.
I'm left-handed, so.
Go ahead and throw the wrist strap on for safe milking.
So if I wanna.
As you watch the video here, notice that the, our actors are, you got the SL and SR buttons, so you're squeezing the milk out of the.
The side button.
Out of the, side, yep.
Okay.
And then it's gonna be the top button. And then as you go down, you're gonna squeeze the bottom button, then release both.
It's like a roll down the controller kind of thing.
Yeah, it's like, and the more that it vibrates, the more milk squirts out of it.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So if it vibrates a lot, you're doing well.
All right.
Yeah.
I'll look for that.
So as you're going down, that's when you hit the bottom SR button.
Okay. All right.
And we've got the stools in here since you can't milk standing up.
Yeah, right? That would be. You would need to jack a cow up or something. I don't know how you would even do that.
Hold your Joy-Con and press the SL and SR buttons. Ready? Milk! Get your hands as you milk.
So, hold both buttons down, Drew, as you milk.
Yeah, kind of move from one to the other.
One to the other, but keep that other one held down.
But a roll.
Now it's spraying everywhere. Now you're getting it. Does it feel good?
You don't even need to look at the screen.
Yeah.
How does it feel though?
I'm getting the top and the bottom rumble.
But how does it feel?
Great. Are we milking the same cow?
That's for you to decide.
Yeah.
That's in your milk fan fiction.
All right.
Nine cups is really good for your first time.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right.
I see milk, they're probably like a six maybe on their first try, so.
I feel like Dan really cleaned up at milk in New York.
That doesn't surprise me.
Yeah.
So Val,
he's from Kansas, so
get us to our
probably,
next game.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
There are probably cows in Kansas. Right team wins.
I feel good about this roll, Corey.
All right.
Where are we going?
Oh, yeah.
I like it.
One, two, three, four.
Oh, you're going. Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Quick draw.
Cool. There you go. Then
have them grab your team. So this is one of the first games we showed off in 1-2 Switch when we introduced the game.
Yeah.
Quick draw. Rules are you're basically in a Wild West shootout, and you try to be the first to shoot the other player. We can let the video play here.
What happened between you guys that made you end in a duel?
You know, sometimes you just do it for fun.
Is it the Majora's Mask?
Killing's as easy as there's breathing for me, Drew.
Oh no. So
I bet these shoots were really fun. Like shooting all these videos were probably was probably a good time.
Wish we had more hats.
Yeah.
Yeah, no props here. Yeah, this game is definitely fun with props. So we're gonna aim our Joy-Con down.
Okay.
And then once they say fire, we'll pull up.
And pull up and shoot.
Pull up and shoot.
Pull up and shoot.
You pull up. If you shoot too early, you'll shoot the dirt.
So. Nice each other.
Okay.
Ready.
This is serious.
Ready.
Don't.
Fire!
You got me. You definitely got me. You
really?
Definitely got me.
I don't know what. We got each other. No, that was a draw.
Wait. Oh, jeez.
Look at that.
Wow.
That
all right.
The first time I've seen that.
Yeah.
Draw.
Wait, what's our time here? 360.
360. That is actually a really good
that's
time.
That's crazy.
Too.
That's, all right.
Wow.
We killed each
this
other.
Was the one, this was
the
one.
This
was
the one. The game
is now
over.
All right. Everyone's dead. Yeah. No one can keep playing. It's no longer a team battle. Carry on in my stead, Drew.
So in the instance of a draw, the team who is behind will get to roll.
All right.
Roll.
Well, good for me. Hey.
Picking up my slack, Jeff.
Let's see what we got. Three, not too bad. Not the best.
Where are we
I'll
going?
Take it.
Where are we going?
One, two, three.
Oh, this is a good one.
Samurai training.
All right.
All right.
See you, Samurai Drew.
I'll give it back to Val.
Known Samurai Drew Scanlon.
Yep.
So each player is actually going to be doing a different action in Samurai training. The offensive player will be holding a two-handed sword, trying to vertically strike down your opponent.
Okay.
The defensive player is using their hands to try to catch the sword in midair. And if successful, then you get to switch.
Okay,
if
the defense catches. And is that a button press, or is that just
catching the sword with your hands, with just motion? You can fake each other out.
Oh wow!
As well, so kind of psychological aspect comes into it.
All right. That guy looks like.
And again, you're really just going to be looking at each other in this game. So once ready, go ahead and push a button. And to sync up, just do an open palm clap. Sync the Joy-Con. All right.
Yeah.
Who will be our first? So Drew is going to be our first on offense. So go ahead and hold up and wait for the cue to start.
Start.
Totally telegraphed.
Yeah. Saw that one coming a mile.
So Val is going to Val's up.
Start.
Whenever you're ready, Val. Ooh.
Nice.
Ooh.
Well done.
Did I get it?
Yeah, you got it.
As this game continues, the window gets
smaller. Oh, it's
going to become
up.
Great adversaries, you and I.
Too early. Too early.
Oh.
Nope, it's still going.
Nice.
Got it. Sometimes that audio cue can be a good fake out though too.
Oh, okay.
If you go too early, I thought that's what he was doing. So wait for the cue.
Start.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Oh.
So now. Yeah. He bows, right? The guy bows.
Yeah.
So how far do you have to go back?
You don't have to be back that far. Oh, I mean, you could just be up here.
Because if I'm back here, then I've got a lot to telegraph.
Yeah, I've seen people do something like this, where it's like they do like the other hand, and then they come down.
Oh,
that's pretty good.
Is that? Yeah. I mean, you're an honorable player, so you would never do that.
But I was thinking more along the lines of stomp your feet, make weird noise to try to psych people out.
Or just
you don't move too much, because then it would just
Right. Or be like, hey, what button do I press? And just distraction. Boom. Yeah. You know, it's
All right.
You play by your own rules. They can be clean. They can be dirty.
Yeah.
All right, Corey. I rolled, but.
Where are we going? Where are we going?
I don't know.
Do the 1-2 switch in an honorable fashion, yes or no? Like, that's when you have
I thought I got
you send out the invite for that.
Oh, sneaky dice.
All right,
sneaky dice. This is a psychological game.
Okay.
So we can sit for this one. It's not it's not really an action game here, so.
Jeff's a psychological guy.
So there are going to be dice in the Joy-Con. You're going to roll the dice. You'll flip them over. And then depending on how many vibrations you feel, that's my roll. So if you feel two, I have two.
Okay.
When you're ready, flip your cups over at the same time.
And we're trying to get the I want to have a higher roll than you.
Okay.
But if you feel that I have
player with the highest total,
three, you're like, oh, Corey, Corey only has three. That's really crappy. So,
so
you want
probably
me to stay.
Higher.
You're probably higher. Yeah. But you can re-roll, so we can actually try to psych each other out into re-rolling. Okay. So.
As it stands, the left.
So you're not guessing at what you're feeling inside. It will tell you very definitively.
I will know
you
Jeff's roll,
but I don't know my own roll.
Correct.
Right. Okay.
Say something like, your number feels pretty low, and they might re-roll.
Therein lies the
you
mind game.
You can re-roll while your cup is facing down.
So while you're, so we're gonna roll, we'll full flip. Okay. And if you don't like your number and wanna reroll, just do this. Okay. And you'll reroll. Once you're happy with your number, flip back over, and that's you saying, I am good with my
this number.
Yep.
Okay.
Sneaky dice.
The one additional rule to sneaky dice, go ahead and push a button to start. In the middle of the TV screen, you're gonna see doubles. Doubles count for like more scores.
Okay.
So if you feel snake eyes, I have the highest score possible.
Right, yeah.
Let's get started.
But if I feel four, you might have a three and a one, which whatever, but you might have eight.
Correct.
Okay.
So. Oh, huh.
Use the vibrations to check your opponent's dice roll.
Yours is pretty good, so you're probably good. Unroll, reroll.
Say something about your opponent's dice roll.
I think I'm gonna roll again. That's how I'm feeling about my roll.
Then roll
That's
again.
How I'm feeling about where I'm at right now. Okay, so I turn.
If you want.
I shake. Okay,
yeah,
right. Okay.
New one, yeah.
Is facing down.
Okay.
But, yeah.
And then I just stop?
Yeah, you can just stop, yep.
If you re-roll, your opponent will be able to feel your new total. When you're ready.
That was a better roll. You're probably good.
I think you're lying. But also, I don't know that I can beat you.
Well, I'm good, so I'm flipping over, but you can re-roll if you want.
Yeah, no, I probably should have tried to guilt you into re-rolling. Because
this player wins.
You had
12. Look at that.
Because you had 12. And I'm like, there's only one way to roll 12.
You had 2
But yeah,
fives.
I had 20. That's crazy. Nice. That's, yeah. All right.
It's best 2 out of 3, so okay. Go one more time.
All right.
All right.
Use the vibrations to check your opponent's dice roll.
This is a terrible roll, so you should re-roll.
I mean, I'm thinking I might want to.
This is a garbage roll.
I might want to re-roll with what you've got going.
I'm keeping it.
You're gonna keep it? All right, well, I'm gonna keep it too.
Game. This player wins.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, we go into the final battle.
Okay.
2 out of 3, all right. Shake it up.
Use the vibrations to check your opponent's dice roll.
It's interesting because you have to account for like a higher roll takes longer to vibrate.
Right.
So you have to be able to. Like,
so if I see you doing like 1, 2, 3, 4 for a long time,
right?
While your cup is facing down.
I think I've got this beat.
I'm gonna re-roll.
If you re-roll,
I'm gonna go in blind.
I'm
locking it in.
When you're ready,
I trust.
Flip your cups open at the same time.
You should re-roll.
I think I got this
game.
Beat.
Game.
Oh.
What?
Oh.
Are you kidding me?
Wow.
Oh, man.
I've never seen.
All right.
Oh, we have to go one more time.
All right.
All right. Come on.
Use the vibrations to check your opponent's dice roll.
You're probably going to want to re-roll this one.
Say something about your opponent's dice roll.
I'm not. I'm good. I trust it.
All right.
Oh, you're re-rolling?
Yeah. Okay, so you have a maximum of 3 re-rolls. Okay.
Your opponent will be able to feel your new total. When you're ready, flip your cups open at the same time.
I didn't even feel it because I'm already good. So
oh, you can't even feel my roll anymore once you turn over?
If I do this, I can, but
I'm
just going
to
trust it. Are you kidding me?
Ha ha!
Congrats. You had like a 7 before that, by the way.
Okay,
so that
yeah,
was actually a good move.
That's what I figured. And I knew there's only so many ways you can roll 11, so I knew you just didn't have doubles.
All right, you're rolling, Jeff. Where are we going?
That one's good. There's some good fake out combined with some practical math odds or whatever in that one.
We are like all about low numbers today.
Yeah.
I don't think we've only seen like 1-5.
Well,
so
yeah, we want to see the most games.
Baseball.
Oh man, baseball.
All right, baseball.
I love baseball.
Drew's Mr. Baseball. Everyone says.
Go ahead and you'll use the wrist strap for this. So we're going to be in the 9th inning of a baseball game, and it's tied. And one player is going to be pitching, one player will be batting.
Guess what's coming.
To pitch, you'll just act like you're pitching a ball.
And swing.
And the batter's just going to listen for the ball to come and swing.
Okay.
Based on the sound of the ball.
So you want to swing right after you hear that sound?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And as a pitcher, you have two types of pitches. You have the, if you're holding down the L, one of them is a fastball, one of them is a changeup.
Okay.
And so it'll be a different noise coming at you if it's the fastball
Correct.
Or the change?
Okay. Mm-hmm. So go ahead and sink in there. And then it'll be, we'll see who's on offense, who's on defense here. It's one inning, so Valerie's gonna be pitching.
Pitcher and batter face each other.
So, and remember, like, we're the audience, so we want to see you guys, like, get into it. Entertain. We want to be entertained as the audience.
We're out here going like, man, baseball, 3.5 hours, who's got the time? But if someone hits some home runs, then I'm happy I stayed this
late. Are you guys drunk yet?
Yeah, but they cut us off at the 7th inning stretch, so. So everyone's, like, starting to sober.
But whenever Val's ready, she can pitch by holding down one of the buttons and pitching. So that was way too slow, but that was good.
It's the start of that whoosh sound?
Yeah, okay. You want to get that.
It's
yeah.
Not oh,
at the very start of the whoosh, well, or you hear the whoosh coming and there's kind of a sweet spot in the...
You'll get it.
Okay.
You'll feel for it. All get right. a feel for it. Hitting a baseball. I mean, if you do it 3 times out of 10, you're a professional.
Yeah.
So that was too early.
Okay. Right.
Too early.
Change up.
Val's like, I've never seen a pitcher smile like that before. There's no balls.
What's this peanut gallery stuff?
You can tell Jason to turn up the speaker.
Strike out, yeah. There's no balls. She's not going to walk you, so you want to swing every time.
There you go.
Nice.
All right,
Val.
So is the quality of the hit based on the timing? Like if he had gotten a little bit tighter, that'd definitely be a home run, but it's a double, so. All right.
I don't know if it'll definitely be a home run, but
okay,
it's gonna, yeah.
So how do I do as many as I can until I get out?
Yeah, you got all one right. out. We're in the top of the ninth, so we're trying to finish the game here. Val, oh, he's calling a shot.
Yeah, that's why I got it.
And she's got two options. So she might look like she's giving you a fastball, but she might throw a changeup. That's out.
Oh.
You hear that slide whistle?
Little
it's probably
a little
foul.
Pop fly.
Yeah. All right. Well, two outs.
Two outs.
Two outs. Top of the note.
Okay.
Cheddar now.
Yeah.
I like that.
Oh, got it.
Right. Oh, nice hit. All right. You got runners on the corners. All right. Two outs. Okay. Valerie can still get out of this with a nice, nice pitch. Nice out pitch.
Yeah.
Come on, ground ball to the second baseman.
Okay,
that's like a balk, I think.
Yeah.
Runner's just forced
you,
in. That's a balk.
Rushed it.
Off the wall, okay.
That's a double or
yeah,
a triple.
Yeah, you never said
triple.
That was.
Hey, all right.
Okay.
Finally, some offense in this game. We got the ninth inning, 0-0.
Do we need a new pitcher to come in?
Relief pitch?
You could do
that.
I mean,
bring in the closer.
You could do that.
So
one strike. All right. Left is working for me, I think.
Yeah, you're left.
Ooh, got it.
And you can change up, Val can change up her speeds as well to try to like force, you know, fast pitch you.
The speed of her body movements.
Just the body movements, yeah. She can.
No bunting.
Okay.
That's not gonna work for you. Oh, man.
I am.
Val, I'm coming at
you. All right, thank you. Thank you.
Lit it up for 4 and 9th, got it.
Line you up.
Hey, I'm gonna say that the wall right there, you know, really impedes my movement.
Yeah.
Right. Change up. Strike. Change up.
There we go.
Right to the fielder.
Mm. Oh, out?
Yeah. So now I have to come back 6.
The home team is in quite a hole. Can they beat the odds?
Be mindful of your surroundings.
All right.
That's a 5 runs, a solid inning.
Yeah. That's a lot of action for
me.
Yeah. All right. So.
Okay, L and ZL. All
right. Val, you want back in?
No, it's all right. Yeah.
What was that?
A batter. You're just going too early.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Strike. Change up. Right to the fielder.
All right.
Bobbled it.
Oh. Oh, bobbled it.
Oh, so different things can happen out there.
Man,
baseball game.
You're robbed.
Right to the fielder.
Try to change up. Change up.
Yeah.
Bobbled it. No.
Better up.
Yeah.
Oh.
Two up.
Oh man.
Okay.
Better up.
You remembered how to catch.
Yeah.
Ooh.
There we go. I'm like trip over the crates. Yeah.
Destroyed the set, but okay, fine.
Better up.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh.
Strike. Change up.
All right. Home run ties it, you know that, right?
Oh, all right. Runners at the corners, you got this.
Right. Home run wins it.
Oh, he's got the backwards hat.
Very unorthodox.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
That's the ball game. The blue team has
well done.
Nicely done.
Corey, as baseball fans, I'm kind of disappointed in ourselves.
All right. Well done, Giants.
All right. Feeling all right about it.
Oakland over here.
Oh, Oakland.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
It's a, you know, the green screen didn't give it away.
Yeah.
All right. It's Jeff's Jeff's
okay.
spin.
Okay, we'll roll here and see where we end up.
I like worked up a sweat in that game.
It's like it's moving.
I really wanted to come back. I took that one to heart. I'm a huge baseball
fan.
One, two, three. Joy-Con rotation.
Joy-Con rotation.
We're gonna make the table.
You can play this game with multiple teammates. Have fun taking turns.
So Val, you want to play this one?
Well, it said we could do multiples. I mean, maybe.
We'll just do two for this one. So we're gonna, we're gonna take the wrist straps off for this game. This game, you'll see that the Joy-Con get placed on a table sideways. The players will take turns rotating them.
Yep.
And the idea is to hold your hand as steady as possible as you rotate the Joy-Con. You're gonna get points the more you rotate it. But when you, if you shake too much, you'll lose the entire turn.
Okay.
You get a zero for that turn.
Oh, so you, at some point you wanna bank it. Right?
Yeah.
Like, I've turned a long way, and I haven't shook yet. I'm going to lock this in.
Exactly. So it's a risk reward. How much do you feel like? And your wrist is going to eventually be at a point where you're like, might be like in an awkward angle. And the more you try to set it down, the more.
But also,
you know,
if you pick it up at a weird angle, you might just move immediately. Okay. All right.
Could you just slide it?
It'll probably shake too much.
Huh, okay.
Take turns and make three rotations each.
So you'll get three turns each. So like Val's first turn, she'll try to do like this, like right, and then set it down.
Okay.
And she'll get points for that rotation.
Yeah.
So as long as you start kind of in the same spot, you'll be good.
All right.
You guys, I don't think have had any beverages. You guys should be nice and steady hands.
That's me, steady hands.
Steady hands.
Oh, steady hands.
Are you ready? Rotate your Joy-Con three times. Left goes first. Gently pick up your Joy-Con.
That's you. Oh, that's me. That is me. Yeah.
Set
right.
it down.
Steady hand, Jeff. Each time it does that beep, that means it's kind of not a good thing. You want to be super steady. Sounds like a Geiger counter.
It does. I wouldn't be surprised if the studio was
radioactive. That's a conservative spin, but got points on the board.
Just wanted to make sure I got something.
Does it matter clockwise, counterclockwise?
You do what you do.
All right, there we go.
Jeez.
Oh.
She's out of control.
Oh. Oh.
There we go.
So I figured three beeps and you were out. I got two and I was like, okay, I should probably. All right. Okay. All right. Okay then.
Gently pick up your Joy-Con, rotate it, and set it down.
Stop talking to me.
Oh, the second beep.
Just the picture.
Ah! Do or tilt your Joy-Con.
Switch.
And again, keep in mind, you can play clean, or you could maybe, while Val was spinning, try to mess
like
her
kick
up.
Kick the table.
Well, yeah,
push
I mean,
her
that
over.
Might be much, but, yeah.
All right, let's see here.
Gently pick up your Joy-Con, rotate it, and set it down. Gently pick up your Joy-Con with one hand and rotate it. Rotate your Joy-Con the same direction as last time. Rotate your Joy-Con the same direction as last time.
Yeah, yeah. So you're going to, you want to keep the whole thing going in one circle.
Okay.
Once you start
from
the beginning.
Oh, yeah, I'm just there we go. I messed up my...
Okay.
Yeah.
This is it. This is number
three. Good one.
You've got to go quite the ways to come back. But we believe in you.
Gently pick up your Joy-Con, rotate it, and set it down.
You have support from your teammate
over
here.
Don't.
Go, Jeff.
Don't mess up. Yeah. Don't mess up. Oh.
Good, great job.
I've got to sit down.
All steady hands.
I it's too big of a deficit.
No. All right, now let's.
But I didn't get zero.
No, so, your first one was actually really
more than 100. That's a lot.
That's right.
I'm feeling better. I went the wrong way. So.
Wow.
Yeah. All right. Spin it here. See what we get.
Anything but a skull.
Yeah.
No skulls yet.
Ask and you shall receive.
1, 2, 3, 4
Oh my gosh. This one I've never seen come up yet.
Okay.
In a team battle, so.
Well.
We're gonna need the wrist straps for this, so.
This looks like a fun
I've got a wrist strap here, you've got one. Go ahead and this is you definitely need the wrist strap for. Okay. So we're gonna need clown suits and red noses.
Okay, I'll get those. All right.
And the objective of the plate spin is to spin your Joy-Con as if it's a like you're one of those
circus
guys.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Spinning your plate. And the objective is to make your opponent drop all of their plates. So we're each spinning our plates just like this. And
but then
might,
is there also a balance component to making sure you're holding it straight?
A balance, and slash, like, just keep spinning. If you stop spinning, you will lose. So what we are going to try to do to each other is actually we might, like,
try
to
right.
make each other. I might try to knock Joy-Con over, right?
Okay.
With all your plates, but I understand.
Just remember those filthy Johann Sebastian Joust tricks.
Right.
Throw a shoe if you got to. You got that chair right there.
I do.
A chair.
We put a hole in a wall playing Joust at the old office.
So.
Patrick, I threw that trick.
Okay, I'm at a rapture.
So be mindful of the surroundings. That's a good tip to start this game.
No.
Whoa.
Oh, that was bold.
She just straight
left
up.
Yourself open. Yeah. Like your hand was just right here, and it was just.
Corey, come.
What have you done to the illusion?
Yeah.
I'm knocking the set.
The switch is a facade! It doesn't even exist! There's no video game here!
It's okay. Jason's 7 feet tall.
Yeah.
Oh, so that was it.
That was it.
Yeah, right. No, that's,
that was my one chance, and I blew it. I didn't know where.
But again, it was bold, and I appreciate that. Like that's the type of thing you need to do.
It's
a winning attitude.
Only one.
And they only got one, so we're
well,
still.
That was me.
Yeah, no, you only rolled a one.
Oh, so you're happy with that?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Pick a player from each.
Oh. I'm gonna put Val in here for the sword.
Oh man. All right.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll have to channel my inner Krista.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So.
Yeah.
So sword fight, imagine you have a broadsword in your hands, two-handed sword.
I frequently do.
You're going to try to defeat your opponents. You each have like 5 hearts, and it's vertical strikes. You can do horizontal strikes. You can guard by holding down the back trigger, the ZLZR. And if you hold the guard while you're vertical, you're basically guarding against horizontal strikes, right? If you guard while horizontal, you're guarding against vertical strikes.
Very skyward sword.
And, you won't need the screen, but we can see who's winning. So to start the game, you're just gonna sync up by striking vertically. And then now strike sideways. And holding it with both hands actually makes it so your movements are a little bit more deliberate. So you're not, this isn't a ninja sword, it's a.
Yeah, okay.
And so to unguard, go ahead and just kind of face each other and hold the trigger. ZLZR, hold forward like that. There we go. All right, you guys are on. In the arena, gladiators.
Too shallow. Strike with more confidence.
Are we playing?
We're playing.
I wasn't sure. It didn't necessarily say go.
You're on. After you unguard in the beginning, you guys are on. You're it's 4-4 right now. 4-4. You guys are countering each other quite a bit.
Oh, okay.
And someone's
I got
too excited. So if you don't remember, if you don't hold any buttons down, that's your swing. Oh, Val got a strike.
Oh.
Val's got Jeff down to two. Now he's like one hand. Now,
This is your super, Jeff.
Oh my God. Val's, I don't know what Val's doing, but it's pretty entertaining.
It's effective.
1-1, next strike wins. Oh my God. Replay.
So I think what I was doing, and I don't know so I was holding this trigger the whole time because I was holding the controller really tight.
Versus.
So I think I might have just been blocking a ton if that works as block. I'm not sure.
Jumping and
getting out there and that's cool.
All right, you guys get to spin.
Oh, he won.
All right.
Yeah, he won.
Yeah.
Oh,
barely pulled it out the
winning
end.
For the longest time, and then you tried to like push a button to like get out of the game and fake him out.
Well, I was like, oh wait a minute, I thought we played Honor around here.
Apparently, problem.
I see how Nintendo does it.
Team Nintendo, we got to catch up here. Oh, are you?
Oh, there we go.
Yeah,
that's the big one.
That's a big roll.
Big money roll. You guys have been waiting for all game.
Two, three, four, five.
Oh.
We've never seen Gorilla ever come up. Ever.
Okay.
So.
Never been to a zoo?
Oh my gosh. Well, let's watch the video for Gorilla. We will each be pretending we're gorillas. We're going to shake our hands in the air.
Okay.
To the rhythm.
Do we care or not?
So we will.
Come on.
So to the beat that they give us, that's how we move our hands in the air, right?
Okay.
So it's one.
Come on.
Yep. So we'll do that, and then once it gets to the end, there'll be kind of a freestyle where a female gorilla will come out, and we gotta go wild for her. We gotta just go crazy.
On beat or just crazy?
Just crazy, we're going wild. So we're just shaking our hands in the air like a gorilla at the very end. The beginning is more like we're going to the rhythm that the gorillas give us. No buttons will be required.
And it's all just, the chest pounds?
Yeah, you don't have to hit your chest just in case you might have a heart condition.
I'm trying not to hit my microphone.
You can move your arms in the air.
or wearing a microphone condition?
Yes.
Move your arms in the air like a gorilla. Be mindful of your surroundings and stay far.
I thought you'd never ask.
Like a gorilla. Okay, out of TV range here.
Hold your Joy-Con and match the rhythm with both hands.
Oh, it vibrates too.
Okay. Try making some gorilla noises.
Ooh. And look each other in the eye.
Okay. Ooh. Hold on.
Come on.
Ooh.
Channel your inner gorilla.
We get a heart for whoever got it. So she.
Yeah, I can get thrown off. Right, off at the other person.
Okay.
Come on.
You pushed it. I can't play this game.
Okay, all right.
Now we just go crazy. Now just like go crazy. Right. Just like go get.
It's my move! And is that, do I get scored on like how many?
Yes!
Oh.
The female gorilla came to us.
That's all right, I think
your appeal
so
was
up. That's our score. I got, so if your performance would have been better, I think you might have won, but.
So what I'm seeing here, plenty of room for improvement for both players.
Oh my gosh, I am like crying right now. We are nearing the home stretch.
Yeah.
So there's probably only, might be a couple more games here that show up. Oh,
uh-oh.
We got a five.
Okay.
Nice.
It's a big roll.
All right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh man. All right. All right.
Got this, Jeff.
Yeah.
This will be my time to redeem myself.
So, copy dance, we have introduced this one before. The idea is that the player on the left will pose and the player on the right will copy. And you want to pose with your, you want to hold the Joy-Con in mirrored hands. So, since Jeff's in the right, you want to go on the right.
Switch.
You're going to pose with your Joy-Con hand.
Yeah, okay.
And you don't pose until it's like the cue, so it's like pose.
So it's like
pose.
There's a rhythm element to it, and okay, all right.
Yep. So Jeff will be posing for the first three rounds, then we'll switch. Valerie will then be posing three times.
Okay.
And then we'll be judged on your performance.
I want you to know, last time I did this, I was terrible at it. Or was I? I don't know. Like, yeah.
A lot of mind games going on.
So, to start, you'll hold your Joy-Con out, just kind of start. You won't need buttons for the actual game, but in a second, it'll just ask you to hold your Joy-Con out to the front.
That's when you strike a pose. Then it's the right player.
Bring your best poses. We want to see them.
Okay, all right.
Copy your opponent. Do this three times, then switch.
Oh, switch.
Now you're
like the thing.
Jeff. It's the, yeah.
Oh.
Hold up. Okay, all right.
All right, let's go.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, ho! Copy.
Oh, you copy, then I, okay. Ho. Telegraph it there.
Copy. Yeah, ho! Copy. Good.
All right, now we're switching, now Val's up.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, ho!
Wow.
Oh my god, you guys were amazing.
It's a master class.
I want to sign up for that class. Valerie. Yeah.
Okay, I did actually win this time.
So we can see here the results screen. Jeff, I mean, you were B's all around. I think
Valerie
had
right
you on
that.
Timing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Straight B's, that's a report card you can take home to mom.
Yeah. Timing. Yeah. Always work on your timing.
So we are at the moment now. If Val rolls anything higher than a one or a skull, it'll be game over. If you roll a one, then
oh boy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, look at that.
That's serious. All right.
Good luck.
Take us home, Val.
Right there. Yeah. Right there. Come on.
Oh. My gosh.
So what you're saying is the company that put out Mario Party put out a game that likes to roll ones at the very end. That's what I'm hearing.
So this is a game that we probably don't want to have these chairs in here at all. Let's just move them for safety. This is a fashion runway game where we will hold the Joy-Con at our waist, and we're going to try to, like, it's going to judge as how we sway our hips as we, like, strut down the runway. It might be better. So we do one. Once you get to the end of the runway, you stop. Then you turn around.
Okay. Should we go like?
Yeah, there's not a lot of space here.
Okay.
So what we might do is
go,
we could probably have
camera,
a camera
walk out this way.
Okay.
Maybe.
We'll make this the runway.
Okay, corner to corner.
Yeah. So we missed it, but at the very end. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go all the way to the end. We'll stop. And then we'll do it that one more time.
Okay, we're
and
going at the same
end,
time?
Yeah, we'll go at the same time. And then at the end, we'll come together for a big finish where you have to pose three times to the camera.
Okay.
So Val, if you want to help us like for the posing beats. And then we'll look at each other as we go down the runway. We have to shake our hips.
Okay.
So go
That's
ahead
a
and
key
push
element.
The button when you're ready.
Loosen up.
So,
And for the big finish, get close and strike.
It's a very artistic shot.
Now, stand across from each other. Put your hands on your hips.
Once your controller's on your hip, go ahead and push a button. Keep it there. And you're shaking your hips as you walk, and we're going to look at each other.
Yeah. Right. Channel your inner supermodel.
3, 2, 1, go!
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Turn around. 3, 2, 1, go!
Yep.
Turn around. Death center stage.
Now we're coming together. Getting ready for the camera. Look at the camera. Get ready.
All together now.
Pose.
Pose. Pose.
I think, I don't know.
I don't know.
Let's, so this is how we did on the runway. You actually got some nice, yeah, you're on the top. Those hearts are, those hearts are good.
Degree of hip shake?
Yeah.
Is that what it's measuring?
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Wait, how much is that?
Oh, you guys got
that was
it.
Close.
Oh, wait, that's me.
Yeah.
Yes.
Dude. We're rocking the fashion runway.
All right.
Thank you.
It's our chance to come back. Roll something.
That was a close game.
Yeah.
You want to go ahead and, you go ahead and roll.
Okay.
Oh, man. Sorry, Val.
That's all right.
I guess anything other than a one goes.
Yeah, but look at that. That look at played. That. Yeah, that's kind of scary. Like.
Oh.
And that just means you guys get to roll.
Roll. Like,
okay.
As long as we get one.
As long as you don't get a skull.
Well, there's skulls still.
Yeah.
So.
The right all right, Corey.
The wheel stops on a colored spot.
It's over.
What skill?
Hey, that runway, that was pretty close.
Thanks.
Yeah. So, we had an opportunity to win at the end.
Big confetti finish. Here we see, we're gonna see the credits actually. Oh, okay. The game will go into, it'll show us who won each game now. Mm. You guys actually did really well. All the memories that we had in the team battle. So you guys you guys got ball count.
Mm-hmm. I remember counting
those
balls.
We got milk, yep. Yeah. We were good at milking. Ooh, yep.
Oh, right, the draw.
Draw. Yeah. We got that one. You guys got sneaky dice and baseball. Mm-hmm. We almost had the baseball come back. Mm-hmm. Plate spin, you tried to like jump off the chair to your
There's
mice. One I thought I won.
Gorilla, you guys just weren't crazy enough,
guess
I think,
not.
There.
Yeah.
But the runway.
Thank you. I mean,
and then you can see the total score. So we had 7, you guys had 6. That was a well-fought match of team battle.
Nice. Well, all right.
Cool. I played a switch.
Yeah.
It's real. It's here. It is.
Yeah. No, that's you. You felt the power. I finally got to check out the HD Rumble and see like, okay, yeah, you can totally tell how many balls are in that thing.
Right.
So.
And you can pick individual.
Yeah. Was there one
like,
game
man, I love
that you
milking.
Wanted? Actually, there's actually one game that. Might be worth showing you before we leave. Fake draw was one. I know you like
all
fake
right,
draw.
Yeah,
so
yeah, sure.
Fake draw, we could end with a fake draw. So fake draw is a twist on quick draw where they'll try to fake you out using other F letter words.
Oh, really? Oh, I see. Okay.
Let's make them go against each other.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a better idea there. So don't pull up until they say fire though, right?
Okay.
Fire!
Yeah. Ooh, I already feel the tension.
Well, Drew's got like more of a cowboy shirt on, so I feel like he's got the advantage. He got the
shish kebab. Shawshank Redemption.
Lower your guns.
Face each other.
Ooh, got it.
Ready.
Intense stares.
Steady.
Just serious.
Fork! Fury! Friends! Fair! Fly! Fire!
No way.
Mine slid off there. It's nice to have it back on, but there we go.
You got it. Jeff got it.
Good ears.
I felt good about that one coming up.
I
was
like,
was that a fake out on fly, or were you actually, did you think it was actually fire?
No. At least I came up enough.
Yeah.
I was just too slow.
Yeah. Go one more, 2 out of 3 on
that. Okay.
I feel like you guys almost
That was a deliberate fake.
Yeah.
Was it? Okay, all right.
So just pushing
any of
the face
buttons
to start again.
Okay.
Fake draw.
All right.
Lower your guns.
Face each other.
I feel like you could like solve a lot of the psych out thing by just playing with your eyes shut, you know?
Ooh, yeah.
Far. Fromage. Fly. Friends.
Lower your guns.
Face each other.
I see how it is.
Ready. Steady.
Far. Friends. Fork. Fruit. Fire.
That was Jeff again. Yeah. That's gotta be Jeff.
Yeah,
dusted.
You were trying to sneak up a little for a
little
shot.
I need all the help I can get, apparently.
That was about consistent. You actually
yeah.
That was pretty good, you know? That was
right around that
too bad.
Similar range there. Good angle.
You got the good angle.
Feel pretty good about
yeah.
it. All right.
Yeah.
So this is out at launch. This is out in like 2 weeks, right?
It's out March 3rd, just with the Nintendo Switch. We've been playing on the TV, but with Nintendo Switch, you know, you could take 1-2 Switch anywhere. You could be playing this.
So that's kind of my question coming out of New York, is that was a very loud room, so you had it on a TV and all that other stuff. Like with the audio cues and stuff like that, is the Switch going to be loud enough for, like, I took it to the park and we played some 1-2 Switch, but no one could hear someone yelling fire, you know, like those sorts of situations.
The volume does get fairly loud coming out of the system in tabletop mode. Of course, if you take it to just a generally loud environment, I mean, you do have the headphone jack, so you could plug in like a portable speaker if you really wanted to get it blasting.
Bring my amp out to the park.
Exactly.
Okay. There you go. Cool.
So you would have options if you really needed that audio in a loud environment.
Okay. But, do these, the wrist strap, what do you call these modules?
The Joy-Con strap.
The Joy-Con strap. Do those attach to the system or?
So the Joy-Con strap would not attach to the console itself. Okay. So you might just want to take those along with your bag.
Or you put them on the Joy-Cons before you put them in your bag or something.
Exactly.
Okay.
All right. Well, cool. Thanks so much for coming out and bringing it by.
Yeah, and thank you guys again for having us. That
was
a blast playing Team Battle. Yeah. I got really sweaty playing baseball. And
that's how baseball's supposed to be played.
Yeah. Really smoked. Yeah, I think.
Cool.
All right. Well, thanks again.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, everybody, for watching. See you later.